Hare Bol, everybody.
Hare Krishna. Somebody
has to mute everybody. It's too much.
Hare Krishna Maharaj.
Hare Krishna Maharaj. Hare Krishna Maharaj.
Can everybody mute, please? Mm-hmm. Okay. Are we ready? Yeah. Well, thank you all very much for your prayers and everything else. And I'm still recovering a bit, still weak and light in the head. And this is my first experiment online, and I'm already like, feeling the pressure. I won't be just resuming my daily streaming and so on. I'll just carry on and rest more and tank up some energy. But we are fortunate. Sorry for Toshani and Advaita. We'll see you. I'm seeing you online now. But they were in the room and just a few minutes ago. Okay. Om Jnana Timirandasya Gnanana Salakya Shakshura Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha Shri Chaitanya Mano Bistam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Tadati Swapadantikam Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasudi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So I'm thinking of how Srila Gaura Kasordas Babaji, towards the end of his life, his eyesight was really going bad, and today he didn't see anything. So it said one day there was a snake coming very close in front of him. And then there was one lady who called out, "Oh, Babaji got saved, a snake, he got saved." And Gaura Kasordas Babaji said he didn't see any snake. Right? So for him, there was no snake. So I've always liked that story because it's all a matter of perception. You know? Krishna has a plan, and Krishna is directing everything in this world. And as such, we just accept whatever Krishna desires. Meanwhile, in this whole episode of being sick, There was one day which was particularly difficult because that day, that's about 4 days ago, when I couldn't breathe. That was a complication. But otherwise, it's just been a matter of fever and weakness and headache and so on. But then they say it works like that, that it comes in the tail, the trouble comes in the final days. The 10th day is supposed to be like a critical day. Nothing happened. But then when it was supposed to be good, suddenly I had a bad day. Anyhow, next day again I was fine. And I'm at the moment. Last 2 days I've been going outside a little. The sun is also shining. So that's good, and I'm trying to do some walking. I'm not yet back in my normal walking shape, but I think walking will help me. That's usually what I do when I need to build up my health. Then I start walking, and that's... So tonight I'm making a first appearance on the internet. I'm a little scared that from today on, everyone will start writing to me, and that will be a little bit more than I can deal with. So don't just all write to me, "How are you?" or something like that. That would be too much. But it is appreciated. And so that's why I'm doing this now. I thought, at least let me be here tonight. Do something Krishna conscious. Okay, I'll just get my iPad. 1 second. So. I've been spending most of my days just with the Krishna book, listening to actually the audio Krishna book, and that's been good. It's sort of, Krishna book is something, it's nice because it's just about Krishna and nothing else. And we can just, just hear different pastimes, and it's very nice. Yeah, so the Govardhan Puja ceremony, it took place on the new moon day, After this, there were torrents of rain and hailstorms imposed by King Indra for 7 days. So 9 days of the waxing moon having passed, on the 10th day, King Indra worshipped Lord Krishna, and thus the matter was satisfactorily settled. After this, on the 11th day of the full moon, Ekadasi, Maharaj Nanda observed fasting for the whole day, and just early in the morning of the next Dwadasi, he went to take a bath in the river Yamuna. Yeah, so it took a long time, this whole Govardhan pastime. Altogether, we can see that the Govardhan Puja took place on the new moon day. And then there were all these rains and huge hailstorms. Although Indra is a devotee, Indra forgot his identity as a devotee. And he wanted to destroy and was ready to destroy the residents of Vrindavan and the cows, which is quite amazing considering that that a devotee can come to such a state. And Indra explained that later when Krishna asked, how could you act like this? And Indra said, I was proud. And then said, yes, proud, but you know, how can a devotee let pride sit in his heart? We must cut down pride with intelligence. Then Indra said, I was angry, I lost my intelligence. And Krishna didn't respond to that. He just walked away. So yeah, this is something that we have to look at. Intelligence, to keep the intelligence very strong, to somehow or other, by hearing transcendental knowledge, by reading transcendental knowledge, intelligence will remain strong. By chanting Hare Krishna, intelligence will remain strong. And by doing devotional service, intelligence will remain strong. To always serve the Vaishnavas, Sushusho, Sadadana, Shavasudeva, Kataruchi, San Mahat Sevya, Vipa, Punya, Tirtha, Nisevana. So, this is our objective, and to carry on somehow or other, serving the Vaishnavas, to keep on hearing. Keep on hearing transcendental knowledge. Today, I was talking with Jayad the last few, so many days, and he's working on this seminar on the four regulative principles. And you might say, okay, four regulative principles, that sounds quite basic. The topic he says there's so many things, and today he got into no gambling. And how Prabhupada then drew from this no gambling, how he drew no frivolous sports, jutam. Because the point he was explaining, I said, yes, I was always wondering about that no frivolous sports. We see it appearing on Prabhupada's first first note, you know, where he is asking them to follow these. And in the Vedic context, the word jutam, which refers to gambling, is also referring to just playing, right? Gambling is seen as a way of playing, gaming, yeah? So then it includes all gaming, yeah? He says, if you start like that, he says, then it goes very far, right? Anyway, he's going to get into that, and we're going to see that. And yeah, that's Chaitvaita Swami. He likes to boil the milk somehow or other, go to the devotees' lives, and I mean, he would start to like include anything. And I was arguing back a little bit just to, anyway, what Prabhupada really wanted, obviously, is that we would spend our time with Krishna. And hearing about Krishna and not spend our time with things that take us away from Krishna. It's difficult because we're living in the time of perfect time wasting. The whole world connected by their electronics is a very powerful time waster. Of course, we can also come together, which is what we're doing now, and that justifies it all. But there is certainly a danger that we're gonna lose a lot of time on the internet. Anyway, my focus is not to pinpoint how we should improve our standards today. My focus is to somehow or other think about Krishna and to just carry on. So it is said that after this whole pastime of Govardhan, then Nanda Maharaj, on the next Ekadasi, had been fasting, and he went into the river Yamuna. And as he went into the river Yamuna, he went too early, and he was arrested by the servants of Varuna, and of course, so Krishna and Balaram, they understood. So it is said that both Krishna and Balaram took action. When Nanda Maharaj is taken away by one of Varuna's servants, Nanda's companions began to call loudly for Krishna and Balaram. Immediately, Krishna and Balaram could understand that Nanda Maharaj has been taken by a servant of Varuna. Thus, they went to the abode of Varuna, for they were pledged to give protection to the inhabitants of Vrindavan, who were all unalloyed devotees of the Lord. Devotees, having no shelter other than the Supreme Personality of Godhead, naturally cried to him for help, exactly like children who do not know anything but the protection of their parents. The demigod Varuna received Lord Krishna and Balaram with great respect and said, "My dear Lord, actually at this very moment, because of your presence, my life as the demigod Varuna has become successful. Although I am the proprietor of all the treasures in the water, I know that such possessions do not make for a successful life. But at this moment, as I look at you, my life is made completely successful because by seeing you, I no longer have to accept a material body. Therefore, O Lord, Supreme Personality of Godhead, Supreme Brahman and Super Soul of everything, let me offer my respectful obeisances unto you." Yeah, it's so here we see that Varuna was recognizing Krishna as the Supreme Personality of Godhead, which was astounding to Nanda Maharaj, because Varuna is a clear authority. Yes, there are these principal demigods. They are powerful agents of Krishna. They are assisting Krishna, like the Agni and Vayu and Varuna and Yamaraj. They're all powerful agents, of Krishna. And like that, they're all, they're all very dedicated and personalities who are in clear knowledge, right? They're in clear understanding about Krishna's position. It's, I'm seeing like people are here now from everywhere, from the US, from Australia. So I thank you all for joining us. I'm I don't have a high concentration level, and I'm finding out, because it's the first time I'm trying to publicly say something. I think that this particular pastime of Krishna, I have always liked it, and I think that Krishna shows his his identity becomes revealed. It was sort of not much further back. There is the wonderful Krishna chapter. And in that wonderful Krishna chapter, all the cowherd men, they begin to remember all the amazing things that happened to Krishna. And it's sort of after Govardhan. And after Govardhan, you know, they are like, well, you know, he can't be an ordinary person. Look, you know, at all the things. This is no longer just miraculous, but, you know, like, okay, when he was saved as a child from Putana, when he was saved from Trinavarta, that was a time. That was a time when naturally he was a child, but he was protected by divine intervention, by the Supreme Lord. But now he starts lifting over the hill, and for 7 days he held it on his finger. I mean, that was like really a situation where you couldn't really think that now Krishna or now Narayan interfered with the whole situation and made it possible. Though now Krishna was doing something that was just inconceivable. So at that time, everyone started to think, you know, I mean, Krishna and Balaram, they're not ordinary boys, you know. I mean, they must be like demigods or something like that. They must be, they must be extraordinary. And then they go to Gargamuni and Nanda Maharaj, and Nanda Maharaj explains what he heard from Gargamuni. And Gargamuni saying that, like, the sun will be like Narayan. And he said, like, yeah, that makes sense. Yes. We knew he wasn't ordinary. He had to be somebody special because he's just doing all these special things. So the question of Krishna as the Supreme Personality of Godhead comes more and more to the foreground, and little by little. But then we'll also see at one point, even when it's known, it's also easily forgotten. Because that is the nature of Vrindavan. Although sometimes the pastimes of Krishna remind of Krishna's transcendental opulences, everyone is easily forgetting that Krishna has all these extraordinary powers. Everyone is simply seeing that Krishna is the most wonderful personality in our village. And he is from our village, and as such, he's like us. So the residents of Vrindavan, they don't think of Krishna like as full of supernatural powers and full of the supreme mystic. They don't think of him like that. They think of him just like a village boy. And when he begins to perform these extraordinary activities, they're kind of amazed. And yet, at the same time, they're remembering that he did do a lot of amazing things. And they, when they start remembering such things, those are amazing to them. So, those things are just nice to hear about Vrindavan, how Krishna's pastimes are unfolding and how the devotees are responding. It's very simple, Krishna book. It just brings us back to the basic pastimes of Krishna, which are in some ways very simple. Krishna is only 7 years old when he lifts Govardhan, so he's very young. So he's like in one sense, like a child, and he's just so the pastimes are also, we see all these cowherd boy pastimes in the forest, and it's very innocent, the pastimes of Krishna. So when we hear this, the Krishna book, yeah, we can gradually begin to appreciate how simple, how innocent actually the spiritual world really is. And that is, is very, very wonderful. It takes for us a change. Like Prabhupada said, that spiritual life is so simple, you might just miss it. And it's just like that. We are so much addicted to so many experiences, and that it's difficult for us to just stay with Krishna. Mind once more, some Krishna, yes, now that's something else. So to actually become that simple, that we will be satisfied with Krishna, that is Krishna consciousness. And that takes a lot of that takes time, that takes, but by regular hearing and chanting Hare Krishna and devotional service, yes, then all that becomes possible. Okay, let me see what you wrote. Where's my cursor?
I don't know.
Who's that? Just reading your messages quickly. Don't overextend yourself. Yeah, I always overextend myself. That's my trademark. Yeah, it's a technical question on the demigods. I can't deal with it, Antaranga. All those things we'll do some other time. I'm sort of find it a little difficult to just sit here and just talk. So I don't want to take on heavy questions. I did good. I was for an hour in the forest today. So, and the sun was shining, so it was cold, but sunny weather, so it was good. I think I got some good energy from there. And otherwise, I am taking it easy. And so Then Kalavati is here. I just saw. Okay. So Kalavati is going through some serious health struggle. And we pray that she will go through these difficulties as quick as possible and recover fully. Yeah. Some people think that the virus is a conspiracy. Yeah, well, if it's a conspiracy, then it still can make you sick. That's what I found. And better don't get it. It's not so much fun. But so I don't know how long this thing is going to take for me to get back to full strength. Let me take a little bit more time. But I'm at a danger zone. So that part's good. Of course, we're always in danger zone in the material world. Just when you think you're out of danger zone, that's when you're really in danger zone. You know, wet stool, dry stool. The wet cowden is laughing at the dry cowden because the dry cowden is about to go into the fire. So the wet cowden is saying, oh, look at you. But the wet cowden will also become dry cowden. So, yeah. But that's the material world. Danger. Yeah. Hundred 92 people. It's a lot of people. And Titanshu is writing. My diet. Yeah, I'm slowly beginning to eat something. Thank you very much. I got your message, Deep Tanshu, today, and I'm of course, you're most welcome. I'm going to give you a reply tomorrow. To be a real spiritual warrior, I don't know, you know. It's like you just get sick and then you're a hero. I think I'm sick and I'm lucky that I get I got better. Nothing much that I did. I mean, you know, what can I do about it? A favorite chapter in the Krishna book. I don't know if I have one favorite chapter in the Krishna book, but I like this portion, you know, of like Govardhan Puja and then Nanda Maharaj being brought before Varuna. That part somehow or other, I like it. But there are other parts also. I'm planning to start speaking on the Krishna book in after some time. But this week I will not resume any daily streams. I will just chill and do a little. When I have a little energy, I'll use it for my own, exercise. Need to do something to be a little bit fit. Yes. But I thank you all for coming out onto the internet here in this this stream. It's appreciated. And I'm just scrolling to the pictures and I'm just seeing all your pictures. I'm seeing Mark in Denver. Yes, and I'm seeing Radharani from The Hague. Yeah, I'm seeing everyone. Krishna Kirtan and Giri Raj. Very good. Huh? Yeah, it's just very nice. And I just can't manage a big philosophical lecture, to tell you the truth. So I'm chatting a little bit, and then I'll just leave it at that. To let you know that I'm doing good, and that I'm looking forward to being back in full action soon. And I should be immune, Mark. I think so. But I'm ready to travel, but they are not ready to let me into the US or into Australia or into India or into South Africa. Yeah, Mark is a real kirtan man. He's like always doing kirtan. But I'm glad all of you are well, and Parantapa.
Yes, Maharaj.
Are you? So you've been well all the time, huh?
Yes. Good.
Great.
Yeah. I never got to check the checkup, the testing, because there was no place to do it here. Yeah. So
yeah,
it's been a week and I'm okay. So
great.
Yeah. Very nice to see you. Doing all well.
Mm.
Yeah.
Mm.
What to do?
Yeah.
Did you visit the lake by the park? Did you go down the hill?
No. That's too far. No, I can't go that far yet. I went halfway.
Oh, that's not bad.
Hmm. Arjun Raja, oh, nice. Well, I'm very glad that, yeah, you're all came. I just came on tonight to let you know that I'm back on my feet, but I think you can also see that I'm not fully ready for the Olympics. And so I'm gonna end and actually take rest. And but I was very happy that you have been there. And somehow thank you for all your prayers, all your good wishes, and I'll be back in a week's time on the same forum. Meanwhile, no need to worry. And I lost some weight. I have to slowly start eating again and just get some strength back. Mm. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Maharaj.
Thank you, Maharaj.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you so much.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.